we're able to feel right with the heart of another. You put yourself in that position, say, okay, if I can feel like this, then I wonder what the other person right feels like. And so it's very important that we begin to understand that for us to really show empathy, that we must be at that point where we indeed feel what the other person is feeling. We can put ourselves in the shoes of that other person and also try to understand where the person is coming from. Now, there's a quote that says, far and away, the best prize that life offers is the chance to work hard at work worth doing. All right, so everybody wants to work hard. Everybody wants to really do what is worth it. All right, but nobody just wants to work and feel like there is nothing. Nobody wants to work and feel like he or she is not part of the system. Everybody wants to feel like he or she is a part of the system. And so hard work, people want to feel responsible. People want to feel among. People want to feel that they're a part of your system. They desire this integration. All right. And so that is what they really want to see. That, okay, come to think of it, is there a way, do I feel as part of this organization or do I just feel apart? And the moment people begin to feel aloof and people begin to feel like they are not part of that system, then there is no commitment from them. Now, let me share with you the three types of empathy that exist. We have the cognitive, the emotional, and the compassionate. Now, psychologists have come to define or realize that there are three kinds of empathy, which is the emotional, the cognitive, and the compassionate. Let me see if I should explain this briefly before we move on, but I think I should explain. So when you talk of empathy, there are into three broad categories, right? And clearly stated, you have the emotional, all right? You have the emotional kind of empathy, all right? And then you have the cognitive, and then you have the other one, which is compassionate. Now let's look at it briefly. I'm going to start with cognitive, right? Now, cognitive empathy is simply knowing how the other person feels and what they might be thinking. It is sometimes called perspective taking, right? And this was defined by Daniel Goleman in his book Emotional Intelligence. Now, he says that, look, cognitive empathy is simply knowing how the other person feels and what they might be thinking. It is sometimes called perspective taking. Now, cognitive empathy is actually concerned with thought, understanding, and intellect. It's very concerned about the thought, the understanding, and the intellect. And the benefit that you get from this is it helps in negotiations. When you have cognitive empathy, it helps in negotiations, it helps in motivating other people, and it helps in understanding diverse viewpoint. Now, this has its own downfall or pitfall. All right, it can be disconnected. Okay, when you have cognitive empathy, it can be disconnected from, or it can ignore deep emotions, right? So it doesn't really put you in another person's shoe in a sense of feeling. All right, you know. All right, if you notice the definition I gave, it doesn't really put you in the shoes of the person such that you feel. Rather, it makes you know. So there's a disconnection in terms of emotions. There really no emotion. So it helps in negotiation and motivating people and understanding viewpoints, right? But it doesn't necessarily connect you emotionally. All right. So it's more about thought than it is about emotion. All right. I hope you do understand that. Okay, now, again, let me also say that it is defined by knowing, understanding, and comprehending. It's very intellectual. I mean, even from the word, cognitive empathy is very, very intellectual. It is not emotional at all. Now, if we talk about emotional empathy, which is the next one, it is when you feel physically along with the other person. You feel, you know, when it comes to emotional empathy, you're actually feeling for that person, right? And you're able to feel through their emotions. This is very emotional. All right, and it's as if it's contagious because you can literally feel what the other person is feeling. Now, this is concerned with feelings, physical sensations, neurons in the brain, and the likes. The benefit of this is that it helps in close interpersonal relationships. This is very important in careers like coaching, like marketing, like management and HR. Very, very important. All right, but it has its own pitfall. They say that it can be very, very overwhelming. An example of emotional empathy is the one that doctors show, right, when they are taking care of patients. You see some doctors who cry when they lose a particular patient, right? So as it sounds, it involves directly feeling the emotions that the other person is feeling, all right? And sometimes you hear them use the word that an empath, right? An empath is someone who has the ability to fully take on the emotional, all right, and mental state of another person. Sometimes it's disconnected from the brain because they are not logical, right? They are connected to that thing emotionally, all right? Now, the last one is compassionate empathy, and this is basically the kind of empathy that does not only understand the person's predicament, all right, and feel with them, but also spontaneously move to help. Now, those with compassionate empathy don't just understand or feel, but they are moved to help. So they have a complete circle, all right? They are moved to help. So they don't just understand, they just feel. So they combine intellect and emotion with action. So you can imagine merging those three things, right? So emotions, intellect, and action. Now, the thing is, their pitfall is very few because everybody is striving for compassionate empathy. Everybody wants to be compassionate, all right? And that is the ideal, right? Because cognitive empathy may be fitting for political and monetary negotiations, right? Or an higher office, right? But emotional empathy may be the first response in children and for loved ones, whereas compassionate empathy strikes a powerful balance of both. So compassionate empathy takes the two of them together, all right, and brings us to that point, whereas the other two are just individually separated, all right. So like I said, let me repeat again, we have three kinds of empathy. We have the emotional, we have the cognitive, and we have the compassionate. So which one do you strive for? Which do you desire? So if you're an office holder, for example, and you're striving for a higher position, right, you're likely to desire cognitive empathy because it has to do with intellect, it has to do with thinking, it has to do with your ability to reason, all right? But if you're in the business of coaching, you are in the business of saving lives or helping people, then you know that the one that you should pay attention to is the emotional empathy. That's the one that you are likely to have because it has to do with how much of help you are to people, all right? But again, everyone strives to have the compassionate so that you don't just feel, all right, but you can also work with people, you can also lend a helping hand to them. I'll be right back.